So why are enzymes so important to all living things? And the reason is they allow cells to control chemical reactions. They allow cells to determine exactly when chemical reactions happen and how much they are producing of a particular product. And it just allows cells to maintain homeostasis. We've got lots of fats, lots of carbohydrates, so let's break them down and store them for later. We don't have any incoming food, so we need to break down our stores. Enzymes are going to be key in all of those processes. There are chemical reactions that are urgent and important, things like making sure your heart beats and you have enough energy in your muscles to get up and walk around. And then you have things that are not as urgent or as important, you know, the protein in your hair and whether it makes it curly or straight. So we have some enzymes that are really, really essential and others maybe not so much, and then some that are sort of in between. So, how do enzymes actually work? This is some basic chemistry. They lower the activation energy for chemical reactions. So what this graphic is showing you is we're taking molecule A and molecule B, and we're bonding them together to make a single molecule AB. And the red line is showing how much energy it takes to get this reaction to happen. So these two molecules have to bump into each other. They have to bump into each other in just the right orientation so that their bonds can be broken and reformed, and then we'll end up with this. And so notice from this line up to this line, that's how much energy input is needed without an enzyme. This is called the activation energy, how much energy it is to get the whole thing started. Notice with an enzyme, the activation energy is less than half. Remember with the induced fit model, the enzyme is going to hold A and hold on to B and hold them right next to each other so that it makes it easier for them to bond together. And so it lowers the activation energy. So activation energy with an enzyme is much lower than without an enzyme. You might ask, why do we have activation energy at all? Why don't we just have molecules that can bond together and it doesn't take any energy to get it started? If there was no activation energy, then all of these chemical reactions in your body would be happening simultaneously. And we don't want that to happen. We want to be able to control them, so it's actually good that they need this little push to get started, but we can use an enzyme so that it doesn't take too much energy to get them started. So again, enzymes and activation energy are just going to allow fine-tuned control of chemical reactions inside the body. Denaturization. This is when you change the shape of an enzyme so that it will no longer function. Remember that the reason that an enzyme can function is because of its three-dimensional shape. It can hold on to a particular molecule. And if you change that shape, it's not going to be able to hold on to that molecule anymore. Some of the things that cause a protein to be denatured are extreme pHs and high temperatures. So if you expose something to a very, very high temperature, it's going to shift the bonds in those amino acids, and now it's not going to work properly. This is what happens to the protein in an egg when you cook it, right? You're adding heat, it's rearranging those clear proteins, the albumins in the egg white, and turning it into something that turns white in your pan, and you've just denatured the proteins. Like egg white, once a protein is denatured, you can't go back. You can't cool it down and get back to the original protein. You've lost it completely and you need to remake a new one. Extreme pHs can do the same thing. So I think we all know that something that's very, very acidic can kill living cells. The reason it kills living cells is that it's denaturing all of the enzymes. Now you can't control the chemical reactions in that cell and that cell's going to die. Very basic solutions will also have the same effect. Notice I don't have cold temperatures on here. When you drop the temperature, what you're doing is the molecules are not moving around as quickly. That's going to reduce the rate of chemical reactions. The molecules aren't going to bump into each other as much, so chemical reactions won't happen as quickly, but the cold temperatures are not going to actually change the three-dimensional shape, and so that will not result in denaturing. So when a person gets a really, really high fever, 102, 103, 104, that's not quite so bad. But once you get up to 105, 106, 107, that is hot enough that you're starting to denature your own enzymes. And at some point, that's going to be fatal because you're going to denature an enzyme for an essential chemical reaction. occasionally you hear about people who slip into a icy pond or out in the snow and they appear dead. They bring them back to a emergency room and they end up coming back to life. This can be explained again because their enzymes have been frozen, they've been slowed down, but they haven't been totally denatured. And if that person is carefully rewarmed, there's a chance that those enzymes will be able to start moving around and function properly again.